Hello everyone, welcome to Semicon Talk. I got a request to explain more about wafer backgrounding process, especially parameters. So, I'm gonna discuss about it. For wafer backgrounding process, we need to start with initial wafer thickness and target wafer thickness. Initial wafer thickness is wafer thickness before wafer backgrounding. It is around 750 micrometers for a 12-inch wafer. Target wafer thickness is wafer thickness after wafer backgrounding. Target wafer thickness depends on device type and its application. It can be 300 micrometers or down to 35 micrometers. This is wafer backgrounding machine and its internal layout as an example. Detail layout can be different by machine, and I will explain based on this layout with four spindles. As you can see, there are four spindles, G1, G2, G3, and G4. If you take a closer look, we can see wafer on chuck table. Over the chuck table, there is spindle. At the bottom of spindle, grinding wheel is located. During wafer backgrinding process, spindle is moving downward with rotation. Also, chuck table is rotating at the same time. So, spindle rotation, spindle down, and chuck table rotation are in action at the same time. With these, part of wafer is removed, and thickness of wafer is reduced. Here are key process parameters of wafer backgrinding. For spindle, rotation speed, down feed rate, and down position are important. In this example, there are four spindles, and at each stage, wafer thickness is reduced. And typically, at first spindle, fine mesh grinding wheel is used. For chuck table, rotation speed is important. Another key parameter of wafer backgrounding is grinding wheel. Grinding wheel consists of wheel base and wheel segment. Wheel segment grind wafer, and there are three elements: abrasive grain, bond material, and pore. Abrasive grain is also called grit, and its size determines grinding performance. Grit size is expressed as mesh number, and higher mesh number means smaller grit size. For coarse grind, people use grind wheel with low mesh number, means bigger grit size. It can grind more and faster, but with more wafer surface damage. For fine grind, people use grind wheel with higher mesh number, means smaller grit size. It can grind less and slower, but with less wafer surface damage. So, wafer backgrinding starts with coarse grinding to grind fast, then fine grinding is followed to minimize damage of wafer surface. This is cross-section image of wafer, and it shows degrees of surface damage. It also shows CMP and dry polishing, but I will not cover these items in this video. In summary, during wafer backgrounding process, wafer is rotating at the bottom by chuck table, and grinding wheel is rotating at the top by spindle. At the same time, spindle with grinding wheel at the bottom is going down. Abrasive at grinding wheel actually grind wafer. If you see some spiral pattern at wafer backside, it is grinding mark or wheel mark. Today, we discussed about parameters of wafer backgrounding process. I hope this can answer for the question I got. If you have more questions, please let me know. Have a nice day and see you again soon. Bye-bye.